For a CT scan.
Is one of the
CT of
indications
the
for CT
adductor.
scan now. What are the other indications for CT scan in a parotid
Deep
swelling?
lobe involvement, involvement of the facial nerve, lymph node involvement, and recurrent parotid tumors.
Good. Recurrent, deep lobe, lymph
Lymph
nodes,
nodes, facial nerve
and
involvement.
facial palsy. Right? So this is about the investigation. Any question?
What is the reason of including pleomorphic adenoma in your diagnosis?
Ma'am, first, because of the age of the patient. Second, because it is one of the
You said
most.
left benign parotid tumor, but you also wanted to add that it's likely a pleomorphic adenoma. We agree with you. Why did you want to write that? It's a pathological diagnosis, no?
Yes,
But you
ma'am.
still wanted to add in your provisional.
Yes,
We are
ma'am.
happy with it, but
She
tell
agrees with
us.
you, but she wants. That's a good question.
Because it is the most common tumor
How
of the parotid,
common?
80%. More than
So 80%
80%
of
of the
parotid tumors are benign.
benign
80% of these benign tumors are
are
pleomorphics.
pleomorphic.
Why is it called pleomorphic?
Because it has different elements. It has an epithelial, myoepithelial, as well as myxoid
Is it a true
characteristics.
pleomorphic, or they used to call it mixed mixed tumor?
Mixed tumor.
Is it truly mixed, or it's just a mistake?
No, it's truly mixed.
Anybody? Anurag? It's pseudo. You're answering? Yeah. That's because the mucin is, it gets organized as cartilage. It is not true cartilage. The elements of mesenchyma, mesenchymal cells, mesenchymal origin is traced in pleomorphic adenomas very commonly. So that's why the question, because your diagnosis is very aptly written. Okay? Now, what do you do for this case? Last few questions and we'll wind up.
I would like to do the basic investigations of the.
No, nobody has time for that. Please tell us investigations to confirm, to support, and treat. You said about confirmation. What do you do to support? Anything important? Anything left? No. What do you offer?
Superficial parotidectomy with preservation of the
What is
facial.
superficial parotidectomy? Quickly.
We go along the facio-venous plane and
Removal
remove
of the
the.
facial venous plane?
The dissection is done
No,
along
answer is we remove the
just.
superficial lobe. Don't answer beyond that. Then I'll ask you what is superficial lobe, which is superficial to the facial
Facial
venous
nerve,
plane
facial
of
venous.
patty.
Yes, sir.
And we will not discuss as to how do you identify facial nerve, but I'll ask you because you're doing well. So what are the landmarks for facial nerve?
There are four landmarks. First,
Four. Tell me the fourth one.
this is a very common mistake. We tend
No.
to tell the number. There are six causes, four landmarks, and then we answer one.
Now the fourth one, Sara, you have to answer that. You
This
did that
lateral
in
to the styloid
Gangaram also
process.
did this. Sorry?
Just lateral to the styloid process.
That's the first one. According to me. So that won't work. Tell us the landmark straight away. You assisted
One,
in a parotid surgery?
yes, sir.
Which one did you use?
The one I'm going to say just now. 1 centimeter inferior and below the tragal cartilage, tragal pointer.
Where is tragal pointer?
The tragal pointer is it's a triangular expansion from the external auditory canal, and it points towards the
No,
facial, the
that's not
trunk
a
of the
complete
facial nerve.
answer.
It's
It
at the
is
junction of the bony and the the
Yes.
bony and the cartilaginous
So
part of
first
the
find
AFC.
that,
Yes, sir.
then you look for the 1.5 centimeter measurement, then you look for the facial nerve, you look for, you keep looking. So that's the fourth one. The first one is posterior belly of digastric.
Digastric.
How do you say what you have found on the table is the trunk of the facial nerve? What you are seeing, how do you say that that's the facial nerve, the trunk of the facial nerve?
Did you get the question?
So.
I mean, I think we have 2 minutes. If you don't know, please say
No,
no.
I don't know, sir.
You're good. So you please tell him.
So one is that it's a glistening white, and secondly, you have to identify the bifurcation. Till you have seen the bifurcation, you cannot say it's the
The
trunk.
trunk.
And the other thing, which is very more important, you'll find vein going along. And it's they're all draining into retromandibular vein.
Retromandibular
That
vein.
is why it is called the facio-venous plane
Of
of
patty.
Patty. And we stick to that plane. Posterior belly of digastric, deep to that, and at 30 degrees is where you find the facial nerve. This is the most reliable landmark. Most of the time, we have found the tragal pointer after we have found the nerve. Okay, so it's like I reached here and then realized that is Qatar Embassy, although you told me that's where you come first.
Correctly.
exactly right, sir.
Yeah, so it is exactly. That's a pointer for here. But I reached here with my sense of reaching. And then I, that's Qatar Embassy. I found a pointer after I found the thing.
So it confirmed, actually.
Then is the third is the you ask the person. I'm telling you all, ask the patient or you yourself close your. Close. I won't ask you to close your eyes. You put your fingers on the mastoid process with closed eyes, looking towards the external canthus, and the midpoint of this is where the nerve is, right deep to it. That's also an important landmark. If the nerve is being looked for in a recurrent parotid surgery, you can trace it with a branch backwards. So that's a retrograde spread. What is pes and serinus?
It is the anastomosis of the nerves that takes place, all the branches of
nerves
the
nerves can't anastomose.
The intercommunications.
What does it mean?
Goose foot.
So the goose foot is due to, these are nervi communicantes. The word is nervi communicantes, between the branches. You preserve them because one can save the other side. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, I think with that we can conclude this case, parotid, all sorted. Any question that you would like to ask? Anybody? Now the house is full. Yes? How about the diathermy that you use? How do you drape a parotid? I think that's a part of the operative. But quickly, can you tell us what is special about draping for a parotid?
Beyond the hairline.
So you don't know?
The shave.
Please learn to say, I don't know. If you don't, you're wasting your time. How do you drape a parotid case? Anybody? Yes. Please identify yourself. You're asking for the second time. Excellent. I'm noting it down. Those who ask good questions, they'll be rewarded. And those who ask stupid questions, they'll be doubly rewarded. You know why? They have the courage to get up and ask.
When we are using nerve stimulator for the parotid surgery.
No nerve stimulator. My question was different.
Okay. We have to expose the angle of mouth and eye.
You keep the angle of mouth
and eye
exposed so that if you're not using nerve stimulator or you're using. Okay. When you're using nerve stimulator, what instruction do you pass on to the anesthetist?
We should not give muscle relaxant during anesthesia.
That's right. Good. Give him a big round of applause, Krishna Rao. And last question. What are the indications for nerve stimulators?
Recurrent, for surgery for recurrent parotid, malignancy.
Which malignancy?
Which
malignancy goes along the nerve?
Adenoid cystic carcinoma.
Adenoid cystic, yes, for perineural. And you have to trace it right up. What Dr. Ratna was trying to ask you, the zone is wider than the parotid, you know, because it can grow along the duct. I think with that we concluded. Which diathermy do you use?
Bipolar.
Any other energy device that you can use?
Monopolo is used only during the dissection of along the.
So you can use steel scissors, no diathermy, or you can use mosquito, or you can use bipolar diathermy carefully. When you're doing it, keep the field moist. The nerve should be always covered. With saline. I think with that we conclude. Give her a big round of applause, please.
Thank you.